Okay, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. We have actually talked about the marketing and communication in the last module. Now, in this module, we are going to talk about very important business function. Once again, this lecture will help you to understand the operation management or supply chain management, a complete course which will be this lecture will be foundation. If you understand this lecture properly, this means you are going to understand the operations and supply chain properly. So let's go. The main objective is to understand the business operation and supply chain. And if you try to understand the operation management, then this means operation management is concerned with converting materials and labor into goods and services as efficiently as possible to maximize the profit of an organization. So there are different operations available in banks. But normally, if you try to understand the goods, for example, if you visit a flour mill, you have a wheat over there, you convert it into flour, and the flour will be packed over there. So this is one sort of operation. So, but for this bank, this operation is totally different. For example, a customer will visit over there, they will issue him the form, you will fill those forms, and the operation manager will open the bank account for you. So there are different operations at different companies. But normally in the product companies, these operations are more visible and you need warehouses and those supply chain concepts and operations concepts are more applicable. So if you see this diagram over here, there are some inputs and you do transaction processes. And finally, output is goods and services. People, technology, capital, equipment, material, and information, they process together to produce a good or a service. So let's talk about the supply chain management. This is a modern name of operation management, you can say, but definitely there is some advanced knowledge which you will study in the courses. But let's define it over here. Supply chain management is the management of the flow of the goods and services and include all processes that transform raw material into final product. So raw material, once again, I will repeat the raw material, like you have a wheat. Then you actually transform it into flour and make a bread out of it. So this is actually this raw material into finished good. Depending on your factory or depending on your product, it will convert into final good. And this is called the supply chain management. It involves the active streamlining of a business supply side activities to maximize customer value and gain a competitive advantage in the marketplace. So that is another definition. Let's now talk some basic of the definition of the productivity. As you know, that is product is something, for example, this paper is a product, this remote is a product. But productivity is the efficiency. Like we have talked about, the manager has to be efficient and effective. So efficiency of the product and the way you produce is, for example, if you are producing 10 mobiles in 10 days and the other factory is producing 10 mobiles in one day, then definitely the production of the other factory is far better than you if the quality is same and the all other things are the same. So productivity is the overall output of the goods and services produced divided by the input needed to generate that output. Like here, what we have done, 10 number of mobiles produces in 10 days. So 1 day per mobile, we divide it by 10. But if you're producing 10 mobiles in 1 day, you divide it 10 divided by 1, you produce 10 mobiles in 1 day. So benefits of increased productivity, actually you can get economic growth, higher wages, profits, increased competitive capability due to the lower cost. So these are some of the advantages. And then we talk about the value. Value is the, if you try to value something, for example, you value this remote once it is really working properly. You value a mobile if it has some specific camera features and all those things. So customer value something about it. If you see like an organization, they create a value out of it. For example, the education is the value being created by Suhar University, special values. IT is supporting us, finance is supporting us, HR is supporting us, faculty of business is supporting, this technology is supporting, and we are delivering you a special value. That is why you are willing to study over here. So let's talk about this definition, the performance characteristics, features, and attributes, and any other aspects of good and services for which customers are willing to give up resources. means giving the money, spending the money. For example, why you give more money to Apple and Samsung as compared to China? Because you feel there is more value for me in the Samsung mobile as compared to China mobile or Huawei mobile. It's simple. If you just take one value, that is the Google Play Store. If you can play it over there, but you cannot play it on Huawei, then you are willing to pay more for Samsung, but less for the Huawei. So then you similarly, you have a value chain, the entire series of the organization work activities that add value at each step, beginning with the processing of raw materials and ending with the finished product in the hands of the end user. So this is the value chain. We will discuss more about value chain. If you see, there are three main features about this value chain. These are some supporting activities. Like here for the recording lecture, we have supporting activity of this IT. So we will discuss more in the class, but here these are the primary activities without which you cannot process your product anything. So if you go over here, that is the margin you are playing and you are actually getting the money out of it. So if you go for example, any product for the sporting activity, from infrastructure, how good is the building, how organized they are, how many air conditions are properly working, how many computers are very efficient. So these are the firm infrastructure sport is happening. Then human resource management, recruiting, training and developing, they are helping you to hire a faculty, to hire account manager for your bank Muscat. So they are supporting you. Technology department, R&D department is giving you additional feature of the products. For example, I can record lecture over here. That is an added feature. But I can give you lecture with the MS Team. This is an added feature which is supported by university to deliver you a lecture online. So these are supporting me, these activities. So if you go for these activities over here, inbound logistic operations, outbound marketing and services, they specifically apply on the product, not on the services sometimes. So for example, raw materials handling and warehousing, where you store your all remotes, all papers, these computers. So this is where you store the grocery in a huge or bulk, in a bulk. So the operations mean machining, where you are actually processing them, sorting them, packing them, or creating floor packs out of the wheat. Then outbound warehousing and distribution of the finished products. So your factory will send it to Lulu, this product floor bag. It will also go, this floor or sugar bag will go to Carrefour. This same sugar bag may go to the other small stores as well. So this is the outbound. You're sending them out of your organization. Then marketing and sales come here, and you do the marketing based on the 4 P's we have studied in the last lecture. We will discuss more in this lecture as well. Then finally, you have the services. You give them the services. For example, if your mobile is not working, you go back to there, and then it may go back to Dubai or China for the repair and services, or they may replace it immediately or repair it for you if the screen is broken and iron thing is broken. Then these are sort of services you provide, and finally this is the margin. So these are some more details we have talked about, and that is all for this supply chain management, and we will see you in the third module. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.